Hey guys, it's another late night at the shop. We're going to get a little bit farther in on this 360 Magnum. And I think we might get the heads off of it tonight. Maybe a little farther. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. All right. First thing we're going to do, see, I got my tub up there for my hold my stuff. Grab him. I'm gonna grab him. All right. You know it.
Cut.
Oh,
never mind. Rockers off of here. Oh yeah. He's got pedestal mount rockers, not the shaft mount rockers like the LA motors do. Kind of wish they had shaft mount, but you got your pedestal mount rocker, your bolt, your guide plate, and push rods. And I might be getting new rockers for these and new push rods and everything. I don't know. I'm just saving the stuff. Well, by the time this motor goes together, I may be able to afford a set of trick flow heads for it. And then I wouldn't have to worry about any of this stuff. Distributor out of there. Cause I ain't gonna use that thing either. Look at stuff. Foliage. Thank you. the spider that holds down each one of these. Each one of these holds this down, and this well, that holds the lifters in place. I can show you that here in a little bit. I'm going to take all these dog bones off. I may have to take the heads off to get at the lifters. That's weird. I don't think I ever had to do that before. Well, I guess I do. Okay. All right. All right, all right, all right. I've got so many sets of those, it's ridiculous. All right, well, now, let's just get down to it then. I normally don't do it like this, because it takes too long. But I don't want to get yelled at. That. Hey, motor. There you go. Now you're back in the spot. Thing I forgot this time. I can find it. I'm a little speedy wrench. Guess I'd use that for putting them back together. Oh, well, we'll do it like that. Yeah. Okay, that's about enough of that. Yell at me in the comments. I don't care. I'm tired of wasting time. Oh my God, I'm a hack. I've become a hack. I can just hear it now. I'm a hack, don't give a fuck. It's my motor, it's not yours. I'm not working on your shit. I'll be damned. Will you stay there, please? Oops, it's upside down. That does not look too bad. No ridge. I'll clean those up here in a minute. Gotta get that other head off, but I am not seeing the cracks. Okay. This is just dirt that fell down in there. I'll clean all that up, believe me. Man, it feels good. Come here, motor. Come back this way. There you go. Well, right there has some gack on it, but it'll all get cleaned out when I chase the threads. Just moved everything around. Damn it. This head pretty much the same. Now that carbon might be in there filling up that crack to where I can't see it. So I'm gonna send them to get cleaned up. After I disassemble them, I'm going to send them to get cleaned up. That's for sure. All right, I jumped ahead a little bit. I got the lifters out. There was a couple of them that were sticky. I got those set to the side. Spin this guy back around here, make sure I'm in focus. Back up a little bit. I know this lighting ain't the greatest, but what I'm gonna do now is get this cam out of here. Get the tools out of the way, because that's how we do things. Spin that in there, or that easy just from this little bolt. I told you she wasn't locked up. Right off. Woohoo! Alright. Those are 13s, it looks like. I'm going to look at it. This little slinger or scraper or whatever it is. I'll hold on to that. I'm getting, I don't know why they put four holes in this thing when there was only three bolts holding it, but I'm getting a timing chain tensioner. I used one before and I really liked it. And it basically takes the place of this. It takes the place of that plate there. Cam out and we're walking. And we're trying not to nick the cam bearings. I'm probably going to replace the cam bearings anyway. Truth be told. Because I'm going to have this engine hot tanked. What does the cam bearing do with that? No, I don't like that. I've always had a problem with these Magnum cam bearings that get, I don't know what it is. It sure as hell ain't for me taking a cam out. But one or two of them always get some weird wear to it. Stop cam. You know what they say? This is what we said when we were kids. You take a cam and you drop it on the ground and it breaks. It was a good one. That one is no good. See, right here, there's always one in these motors. And I don't know if LA Motors are the same way. I don't know if you can get in there and see that. I'm gonna fight here, but it's right there. Hold on. See that? Now every one of these cam bearings looks good except that one. Every time I pull a Magnum motor apart, like I said, I don't know about the LA motors, but every time one cam bearing is messed up. And what's bad is it's a different one every time. Different cam bearing. I could see it was a defect. Okay, there's one cam bearing goes bad at every one of these motors. But no. It's a different cam bearing. I don't know if anybody else has run across this, or if I'm just crazy. Or unlucky. But yep. Every time. All right, well, we got her flipped over. Made a little mess. Throw a couple rags on the ground. So I'm not walking around in river water. That sure looks like fucking river water to me. All right. Now. Slave to a battery. Oh, look, I had another one. Before I leave tonight, I put that one on the charger. I'm in a big old mess to clean up here. I thought I was gonna have to use Mr. Hammer, but I wasn't. Oil's just got a weird tint to it. It's not like milkshake, but oh, it's close. I broke it, but one piece oil pan gasket for Magnums. Those are good. Good idea that they had. Broken dipstick. All right, I think what we're gonna do, friends, we're gonna pop off one main bearing and one rod bearing. We're gonna take a look at it Then I'm going to end the video with that. And I'll end up taking it the rest of the way apart off camera. Then later on, I'll do another video on prepping the block. Well, we'll get a piston out. We'll get a piston out. And later on, I'll do a video on prepping the block for the machine shop, what I like to do. And we'll take a look at it. If anything else arises, I'll bring it up with that video. Ain't no sense in watching me take out 8 bolts and all that crap. We'll get this piston on right here. I like him. I can catch him pretty good. Ooh, that's a lot bigger than that. All right, let's start with the main cap. We're just going to do this easy one here. And that's really how they should come out. Once you pop them loose, oh, that smell. If you've never smelled that, I'm sure there's a lot of people out there that would hate it. Yeah, I almost smelled that bolt. It's just something about that. I don't know what it is. But when you pop them main caps loose, something just comes out. Ooh, I live for that. All right. Clean rag. Give her a wipe. Look at that. Ain't nothing wrong with that bearing. Nothing. As far as that bearing goes, that motor run another 100,000 miles. At least in my book. I broke this for you a second ago. I cheated. I know. Man, if the rest of those mains look like that. I think my machine just said $25 to give the crank a quick polish if that's all it needs. I got a good machine, this guy's. He don't try to gouge people. Now these rod bearings, on the other hand, may show a little copper. Yep. I knew they would. But I'm not seeing any gap. Any. It's a line on that one, but I don't know. I think that's part of the bearing. That's a perfect line, but yeah. Now, when you see copper on bearings, yeah, time to change them. Time to have crank polished. My machine just will mic out the crank and check it out real good and make sure it don't need, you know, it might need turn tin. I don't know. Yeah. That piston came out real easy. This thing might need to go 30 over. I don't know. I never had one come out that easy before. It might be, but that bore might be wore enough. I may have to do a 30 over bore on it. I might do it just to make sure that the bores are straight. 30 over pistons don't cost no different than standard or 60 over. You don't want to go more than 60 over on these motors. I don't care if they say they could take it or not. Skirt's got a little, not really even scuffed, I wouldn't say. Top of the piston looks good. I mean, I've seen these a lot worse. I've seen them with lines in them. You know, you get some trash in there. Yeah, where that piston rocks in the bore. That just ain't too bad, though. Oh, and what I am going to do, I've got a set of numbered punches. And I'm going to go through. That's another thing I don't really care to do on camera. But I'm going to go through and one, two, you know, three, four, match the caps up with the rod, make sure that's all good. Journal don't look bad at all. It might need some polishing, but other than that, I don't see it. Like I said, my machinist will mic them all out and inspect everything, and he's honest with me. I trust him. All right, guys, well, like I said, I got a piston out. I mean, maybe you guys wanted to see it stripped all down to a bare block, but I mean, what I just did there and there, I'm going to do there and there and there and there and there and there and there, same shit. So, and like I said, if something shows up, when I do the video on prepping the block, that'll be the first thing I show everybody. It's like, oh, look at this, it's fucked up. But, you know, I think I got a good engine. All right. Well, that'll about do it for tonight. It's 3 a.m., probably time for me to go home and go to bed. I got to go to work tomorrow. I'll see you guys later. Like, share, subscribe, or don't. I don't give a fuck. Bye. Well, there she is, all taken apart. Cylinders look pretty good. That's just some residual dirt from scraping.